Hey nerds, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be doing all things SpongeBob. Today we're going to be opening some new SpongeBob pops that I picked up. We're going to be looking at some SpongeBob customs that I made, and then we're going to look at my overall SpongeBob display. So first we're gonna go through and look at the new pops. There's four of them. I'm sure you guys have seen them a million times over, but I have yet to unbox them, so let's do that. The first pop that we have is the Imagination SpongeBob. I actually picked up like four of these because one I wanted to keep as this SpongeBob, and then the other three I'm using to make customs. I've already turned one into a custom, and I think I have either one or two more. I can't remember if I got three or four, but there'll be more customs on the way. So let's open up this bad boy. All right, so this is the Imagination SpongeBob out of the package. I have seen this one up close and personal, but I only saw it really briefly, then I tore it apart. So this is him. I love this because I've used GIFs and memes of this and just like referenced it a lot in conversation. So it's really awesome that they made this into a pop. And I'm excited that I now own it. Next is Squidward. So this is Squidward in like a ballet performance. Let's go ahead and open him up before we keep talking. Now, I did not get the Squidward because of his pose or his outfit or anything like that. This is iconic, to a specific episode in SpongeBob, but I just got it because it is clearly Squidward, and I do not own any of the OG SpongeBob pops, and I probably never will because I'm not paying that price. So, you know, the new version will have to do. The next one is Patrick. That's what Patrick looks like. Oh, these are all the ones that came out together in the set. I forgot to show you guys that before. Patrick looks really good, and I'm actually okay with him having this board in his hand and this hammer, board in his head and hammer in his hand, because like that just speaks to who Patrick is. I know this is specific to an episode, but I'm just cool with it in general because like that's so Patrick. And I love Patrick's design. I mean, he's super simple. Only thing I don't like about Patrick's that they make are just his eyes, because they're just so big and black and round, and it just makes him look weird. But I don't know. As a whole, I'm cool with him. I like this. I'm glad to finally have a Patrick. And last but not least of the regular pops is actually a Hot Topic exclusive, and that is the band Squidward. This is where they sing at like the Super Bowl or whatever, and he is just rocking out. So this is what he looks like. Originally, I was not going to get this SpongeBob because I'm not somebody who likes to have multiple versions of pops, depending on what it is. If I just get one, then I'm happy with it. But this was during like my spend all of your money phase, and phase is still happening, but I had hot cash and I was just like, why not? And he'd be good to add to the SpongeBob collection because I was growing it with customs, so why not get this one too? So I'm glad I got him. He's gonna look good up there with the rest of the pops. I forgot I do have one more new SpongeBob pop. I already opened him and took him out of the box because I was just finally ready to see him and put him on display. I just did it like 2 days ago. I guess I could have waited, but oh well. That is 10-inch SpongeBob. So there was so much talk, you know, he's actually not 10 inches. I forgot how tall he actually is. But I'm okay with him not being like the full 10 inches. He is a lot smaller than the box, but again, I'm okay with that. He's gonna look, well, he looks good up on the shelf where I have him. Now, let's move on to the customs. This is what I'm excited to show you guys. So I have two customs. This first one is like my second custom I ever made, or third or something, pretty early on. Not that I've made that many, but that is Plankton. So I made my own. Woo, almost dropped him. Woo. Wow. That's the unfortunate thing about this Plankton. I've dropped him so many times. He has so many cracks and breaks and just, he's falling apart. So this is Plankton. See his arm is like broken right here because I've dropped him. Oh wait, can you see me? His arm is like broken right there because I've dropped him. He has like cracks all in the front of him and on his legs and stuff. But so basically I made this plankton from scratch. I try to get pops that I can like manipulate and change and use them as a base. But this one, I had to make my own base. So I made plankton completely from scratch. And this is the final product that I got. You know, this is his expression and whatnot, his little antennas and his unibrow. And yeah, so I'm very happy. And then on the back, I just created this little hole before I baked him to set. And then I have one of these little arms from my like acrylic arm things that people use a lot for statues before statues started coming with their own. Like I have right there for the, Flying Goku on the Nimbus. So same thing, I got it from that pack. And I just pop it back here and then he's able to just stand up. He's not gonna stand on my hand, but yeah. You get the idea. And then, last but not least, we have Doodle Bob. Me hoi minoi. This is Doodle Bob. So I took one of those Imagination SpongeBobs. I ripped his arms off. I cut down his legs and his feet. And cut down parts of him, covered him in some additional clay. Made his arms and his legs and feet and the pencil and then baked that all together and then painted it. So the base is I did with a spray paint. I bought an airbrush gun and compressor and paint and stuff to help me with my customs. I'm glad that I did. It's fun. It's a learning curve, but it's interesting. So I painted his base this like off-white color, off-white grayish color that I mixed together. And then I made his like mouth out of a layer of clay and his eyes and nose out of a layer of clay. And then I painted all of those things. So when you look up close, there's more defects than like far away in a picture. But yeah, so I painted all that. I painted like the base on. Then I flicked little paint on there to make all of these little grainy color details like they have in the SpongeBob sand. And then I went in with a paintbrush and black paint and did his whole outline that's supposed to be like big and bold and yeah. And then painted on the details of the pencil. So I'm super happy with how he turned out. There are so many imperfections and things that I can clearly see and that's easy to see. But I don't do customs as like a job. It's just a fun hobby for me to make some that I would want them to make. So I'm very pleased with the outcome of Doodle Bob. Okay, so this is the SpongeBob display. Sorry, the lighting is weird. I got my lamp on over there. But if you guys remember, we did a SpongeBob playset unboxing and review of this little Krabby. Nope. What's the name of it? Where does SpongeBob work? Krusty Krab. Nothing. Okay, so this is the SpongeBob display. Please ignore the awful lighting. My lamp is on and this isn't my normal filming location. But this is the Krusty Krab and the Chum Bucket from, ooh, it's dusty. Ooh, Lord. From the playset unboxing that we did a while ago. I wanted to get them to do with a SpongeBob display. And yeah, back there we have the little cutout from the Pop Town, the little backdrop. And I decided to put it there because I feel like it ties it all together and it looks good. Then we have SpongeBob's pineapple from the Pop Town and the SpongeBob that came with it with the little Gary. Ooh, that lighting though. Okay. But you get it. There's SpongeBob and Gary next to the Krusty Krab. Then we have Doodle Bob there trying to wreak some havoc. Then we have Plankton next to the good old Chum Bucket. We have lots of dust that I need to get rid of. And then down here we have our 10-inch SpongeBob and our Squidward. More dust. We have the band concert SpongeBob up on top of the first four seasons of SpongeBob on DVD. plus a bonus movie. I recently bought these from somebody on Facebook Market for a really good price, and I wanted to add it as part of the display. And then we have Imagination SpongeBob and Patrick Plank of Wood. So yeah, that's the SpongeBob display. I'm probably gonna move the 10-inch SpongeBob and the Squidward over some more so that I can fill in the space with some other Nickelodeon pops, because lots of Nickelodeon stuff that's not up right now because I'm still working on it, so don't judge me.